চরণারবিন্দ। নিখিল ভুবন মায়া ছিন্ন বিচ্ছিন্ন করতে বিভূত বহুল মৃত্যা মুক্তি মহান্ত দাত্রী শিথিলিত বিধি রাগারাধ্য রাধে স্বধানি বিলসত হৃদি নিত্যম ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত বাণী। ওম নারায়ণ নমস্কৃত নরঞ্জীব নরোত্তম দেবী সরস্বতী ব্যাসম তত জয়ম দিল। ইট ইজ মাই ফ্রেন্ডস এন্ড দি দোজ হু আর হিয়ার অ্যাসেম্বলড, আই কর্ডিয়ালি রিসিভ হিম এন্ড ভগবান কি কথা সবলেচ্ছু সজ্জন মাতা মা সবিক বন্দনা করতাম। ইট ইজ মাই হাম্বল প্রস্টেশনস এট দি লোটাস ফিট অফ নারায়ণ মহারাজ। সমটাইমস হি ইজ সো হাম্বল টু থিঙ্ক মি হিজ সিনিয়র গড ব্রাদার। আই অলসো অল দি টাইম থিঙ্ক হিম অ্যাজ মাই সিনিয়র গড ব্রাদার, ইউ নো we are of the same family, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati family. We work together sometimes in this foreign land also in Los Angeles and preach there very nicely together, dancing, chanting, you know. So I'm so much delighted to see him here. Astonishing. It is very delighting to me. The thing is that Krishna, this in short form of lecture, this can be presented to you. We are from Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati's family. And it was my marvelous to think of, it is marvelous to think of that our previous brother, like very friendly to us also, his divine grace Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, widely known as Prabhupada, he lived with me there in Vrindavan, in some rented home. Nothing, no what was there, Gaudiya Math, I mean, this Chaitanya Gaudiya there. And that Swami Maharaj, revered Pujyapad Swami Maharaj, and His Divine Grace Srimad Keshav Goswamiji Maharaj, in that role, our Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Maharaj has come. I saw him when he took sannyas at that period. My Guru Maharaj, Madhava Goswami Maharaj, His Divine Grace was there in Guwahati, in Dr. Chatterjee's home. He and Brahman Maharaj, revered Brahman Maharaj, they came both there. As in that, you know, we are this contemporary of the same age. So that time I first saw him, both Bhavan Maharaj and him. Now, it is very exciting that all the time he is improving in his preaching. He is now second form of Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj now. He is so kind to preach all over the world with the Swami Maharaj disciples, you know. He is not no other than Swami Maharaj and his scholar Gaudiya Math. We belong to same family. We'll be thinking, very delighted to think that we are of the same family and we are trying to get world is one family by Harinam Sankirtan. The whole world, we want to grasp the whole world, the whole Brahmandas, innumerable Brahmandas, even. Krishna includes everything. So we chant Puri Nam Sankirtan. We also following his divine footsteps, Krishna's. We want to get four Brahmanas in our family. All over the world we shall be teaching. All over the Brahman we shall be teaching. Our Guru Nanak Goswami preached all over, you know, all the time. So in brief, he gave me 10 minutes to speak. Apparently what this perceptive words are here, sensitive words. As we touch from our eyes, from our ears, from our mouth, from our eyes, we touch this material world. This is material world. That is under misery all the time, you know. So that is in Sanskrit called prayo. Apata mananam, ultimately that will give some dukkha, some pain should be there, arising. Inevitably, pains are inevitable in this material world. And here, we the jiva souls, you know, crawling for death all the time. Sarvato mrittu upasam avaruttamoi. So, we want to cross over this material world. And so we want to enter into the spiritual world. What is that? Naam vigraha sarup. This material world will not speak to you anytime. That is not speaking also, not talking to you. You may be thinking that this material world with wife, husband, children, they are talking to you. They will not talk. They will be disappearing gradually, one after another. But this Harinam, Hari Vigraha and Sarup, that will always be continuing to guide you. And that is inevitable that we shall get our shelter there only. Harinam will talk to us. Harinam talk to Ratnakar Vyakwet, who brought Ramayana here, Valmiki Muni. Harinam talk our that Rajami, Harinam, even the kings of Harinam talk with Hari, you know, Ajami, most greatest sinner of this material world. And you know, that Sipikra, this kind of inimitable persons, Gogai Mahe said, inimitable persons are there, this Harinam talked to them. He did not throw it away. Anyone, that Harinam gave the shelter to all. All kinds of sinners got shelter at the lotus feet of Harinam. For me. So that Harinam is Ram Nam Sutta Hai. It is all the time trumping of heart. All the time. Resisting us, all the time giving us shelter, Harinam. And Hari Vigraha, Hari Vigraha, the Sakshi Gopal, Kirtana Gopina, Jagannath, you know, and, you know, Nathadwara, that Sinarji, they're talking all the time to his devotees. So they will never be depriving us as like this material world. Oh, here we are with wife, children, husband, and so many things. They will not talk. They will be gradually disappearing. So it is a great thing to think that Pujyapad Narayan Maharaj giving Harinam to all. So they will, that is the highest kind of, you know, that preaching as well as that is good asset distributing to the whole world for Brahmandas. Harinam and Sri Vigrahas are being installed different places to give shelter to all the rotten jivas, fallen jivas. Adhamar Patitajam Yadi Tale Tale Giya Harinam Mahamantra Jan Vilaiya. So he is so kind enough, our Pujyapad Narayan Maharaj, he is giving Harinam donating, he is distributing Harinam to all the fallen souls also, to get them resurrected from this fallen land. But nobody is talking to you. All are silent. All are silent. They are Sasan Mandav. They will take me to the cremation ground. Crematory only. But he will not be taking to the cremation in another opposite side. He will be taking all to Vaikuntha, to Vrindavan. Sarvadharmān parityajya māṁ ekam śaraṇam braja aham kāṁ sarva pāpebhyo mokṣa iṣyāmi mā śiṣyo. So you all, jīva soul, you come and take Harinām. Harinām that will disperse all kinds of moha, fascination, nesaya. Harinām mahamantra laha tumi māgi. Elechi, aushati, māyā nāsi paro lagi. Harinām mahamantra laha tumi māgi. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Bhagavati Vinoda Prabhu, charane pariya, Harinām mahamantra roilo māgiya. So that Harinām mahamantra will talk to you. Your wife will not talk to you. And he, she or he is not, they are not talking to each other. No exchange there, karma phal. Only they are enjoying karma phal, fruitive actions of the past. Because we are averse to God. Being averse to God, we are suffering in this material world only. So it is very nice to think of that those who are under Gauriya Math, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's footsteps, they are rectifying, they are purifying the whole world. Amongst them, Narad Maharaj also purifying us, me like the rotten soul, the humble one, the layman, you can say. So it is supreme kind of donation, rather supreme kind of blessings, supreme kind of friendliness is dispersing, he's dispersing, he's distributing to all. But Jiva Sotha, he is the Sotha, he is the confident friend, bosom friend to all. So may Lord, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, and his, all the Goshti, all the family, ashar blessings upon him, so that he will gradually try to continue preaching, because our age is now gone. We are going to death now, 83 now. He also almost maybe 2-3 years, maybe bigger, I mean the senior. So he sometimes told me that, no Maharaj, you are senior to me. And today he is saying that he is 88 now. I am 83. So we shall be crying today, but you, the disciples of our Gauriya Math, it is my proud privilege to think of, you all are the Gauriya Math disciples. Not ISKCON, etc. otherwise. All Gauriya Math disciples of the same family, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. So we shall be getting together and preaching very nicely. So long we shall be living here, living in this material body. Because the Harinām will talk to us, Sri Vikra will talk to us, and in the Swarup, in that real form of existence of the Lord, that Nam Vikra Swarup Tin Akiru, Tin Chidanand Guru. So he is waiting for us he is waiting for us. It is in Dvaita Dharma also, that he is all the time waiting for us, because we surrender our this sadhinata, that we free will at his lotus feet. We should not misuse sadhinata. We should not misuse free will according to our own way for my enjoyment, but for the pleasure of the Lord, we should place our sadhinata, this free will, at the lotus feet of the Lord, and we will receive all kinds kinds of opulences, all kinds of prayer of the Lord at the lotus feet of the Lord Krishna, Gaura Krishna, and we shall be, you know, distributing them to all of the Brahmandas, not only this material world, universe. So we are all the time praying to the Lord. So may our dear Narayan Maharaj be progressing in his last stage, you know, progressing more and more, more and more, more and more. Thank you very much. Very, very kind of you that you all are assisting him. I am very much grateful to you all. Thank you.
Om Jnanam Timiram Dasya Jnanam Jana Salakaya Chaksurum Nitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Nama. First I offer my unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my most worshipable Diksha Gurudev, Nityalila Pravishta Om Vishnupada, a stove to the Siddhashri Srimad Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, and the same unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my most worshipable Shiksha Gurudev, Om Vishnupad, a stove to the Siddhashri Srimad Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, to all of our disciplic succession and all the assembled devotees. Srila Gurudev has ordered me to speak a few words of introduction. The introduction to our coming here tonight is as follows. Brahmanda Bhumite Konya Bhagya Vanajiv Guru Krishna Prasade Paye Bhakti Latavij. We've been wandering throughout many, many millions of universes in 8,400,000 species of life, and suffering throughout hellish planets, trying to enjoy in heavenly planets, just like a roller coaster, up and down, under the strict control of Maya. But here and there, through various lives, we have performed what's been called sukriti, or spiritual pious activities, unknown and known spiritual pious activities. And thus, we got sanskars, or impressions on our hearts, over many, many lives. And what is the result? Bhakti stu bhagavata bhakti sangena parijayate satsanga labhyate punbir sukritai purva sanskritai. After many, many millions of births throughout different species of performing spiritual pious activities and getting sufficient impressions, good impressions on the heart, one meets a bona fide devotee, manifestation of Sri Krishna himself in the form of a bhakta, a pure devotee. And by the association of the pure devotee, one gets bhakti. What is bhakti? Whatever we do, whatever we think, whatever we speak, whatever we offer or give away is simply for the pleasure of Krishna. And the highest examples of bhakti are in Goloka Vrindavan, Krishna's parents, his friends, his beloved gopis. So Sri Guru came from that realm to bring us to that realm. And what is the process? Satam prasangam mama virya sambido bhavanti ritikarna rasayana katha taj joshana jaswapavarga vardhmani shadav bhagvatir bhaktir anukramishyati. Lord Krishna himself, in the form of Lord Kapila, gives the process. by associating with my pure devotees, who are my own associates, who've come from that realm, the spiritual world, in order, as Sripad Mangal Maharaj mentioned, who comes here to get all the buds of flowers, or seeds of flowers, or wilted flowers of souls, to make us blossom and become offerable, and then he offers us to Radha and Krishna in the spiritual world. So that sat, that eternal associate of the Lord, Lord himself says, in association with that caliber of devotee, those who hear about my glorious activities, they become purified. First, that transcendental sound vibration, that Shabda Brahman, comes from his glands. The prana atoms come from the portholes of his body. And from his lotus mouth comes the transcendental sound vibration that carries the aroma of the saffron dust particles of Krishna's lotus feet. It enters into the ears and satisfies both the ears and the heart. And tajjoshanat asva pavarga vartmani, one proceeds straight on the path of liberation from pavarga, pavabhagama, the material situation of great hard labor, just like a horse is laboring so hard that it's foaming at the mouth. And for what? For death, and then going down again to the lower species of life. Chewing the chew that our relatives are in, our ancestors have chewed. One chews bubble gum, throws it on the floor, it mixes with all the dirt in the street, and then the next person picks it up and chews the same thing. Puna puna chavi to chava na na. Chewing the same already chewed. So hearing from the pure devotee the beautiful, glorious pastimes and qualities of the Lord, one proceeds straight on the path of liberation and goes from shraddha, faith, that if I just serve Krishna, all my other activities, all my other goals of life are taken care of. Going from shraddha to anartha nivritti, being freed from all unwanted habits and thoughts. Going to steadiness, to pure taste, to attachment from the Lord, just like a lover has a spontaneous attachment to another lover. It's no duty, it's just natural. So one comes to the platform of natural attachment to the Lord, and then ecstasy, transcendental, ecstatic moods towards the Lord, and finally praying, Shuddhar, Ratir, Bhaktir, Anukramishati, step by step in that divine association. So now, after so many births, we have that great association. We had Srila Prabhupada, and by his mercy, he's brought us also to Srila Gurudev's lotus feet, where we can have his lotus feet, Prabhupada's lotus feet, on the lotus feet of all of our Guru Parampara in their association in the spiritual world. Thank you.
First of all, I pay my humble obeisances under the trust of my Paramaratha Prabhupada Padma, Om Vishnupada, Astotra Saptasya Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Goswami Maharaj, and Om Vishnupada, Parirajakacharya Varja, Astotra Saptasya Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Goswami Maharaj. I pay my obeisances to the trust of my spiritual grandsire, Nitya Lila Krishna Vishnupada, Srila Bhakti Pratyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj, and Nitya Lila Krishna Vishnupada, Srila Bhakti Goswami Maharaj. We pay Vaishnavi senses, all Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis and guests assembled here, headed by Param Pujyapad Srila Bhaktivinoda Mangal Maharaj. Srila Gurudev ordered me to speak some Harikatha. Just before you have heard from our previous speaker, we have heard from Srila Gurudev, and it is true, in this world, all are seeking for happiness, hankering for happiness. No one wants any unhappiness. For this reason, the science has discovered so many things. Today you can see the transportation, communication, medical science, how much they developed. If you go to 100 years back, nothing was there. And nowadays, so developed. Why? They want more and more happiness. Are they happy at all? If you go 100 years back, each other they have some love and affection. Nowadays, love and affection go far away from us. As before, we know each other, but nowadays we don't know who are our next neighbors in our next flat. We don't know at all. So what is the result of improvement of science? They take our love and affection from each other. If you want to be really happy, then what is the process? Bhagavad told that nittati deno vittena durlabhena atma mrityuna griyapatta kasubi kapati sadhitashtaloi. We are hankering for money. And this money will give us eternal happiness. If you have much more money, you have much more anxiety. And we are thinking, money is money sweeter than honey and brighter than sunshine. It is not true at all. So this money will not give you eternal happiness. What you incoming or earning by money, this is the cause of your anxiety, not eternal happiness. If you earn much more dollar, you not need dollar, what you are taking foodstuff every day, you have to do the same thing. So why we are working so hard like a junkie? Even when we give up this body, even you cannot take with us a tip of hair what to say about which art in this world. If you really want to be happy, then what is the process? Prahlad Maharaj told to follow all that Kaumara Acharit Prakto Dharmayana Bhagavataniya Durdhava Manusa Janma Tadapadhuva Martadam. You have to practice bhakti yoga from teenage, from childhood. Then you can advance in Krishna consciousness or be eternally happy. Why not? If we do bhajan in old age, Prabhupada Maharaj told to us that in this world, if we think our average age is 100 years, then we work in daytime and sleep at night, special weekend and sleep too much. Almost 50% is spending in sleeping. And left over 50%, 50 years. The old age, 80 to 100 years, at that time, we could not walk without any help of stick. At that time, so many diseases attack us. And at that time, we want to speak something, we forgot want to speak. Devotee is telling, Krishna Tadya Pada Pankaja Panya Rantam Matnai Babisatu Manasa Raja Hamsa Prana Payana Samaya Tavavata Pittai Kantha Varadanam Vidau Bhajanam Kutaste. If you want to do bhajan in old age, not possible at all. At that time, you are neglected by your families, have to be in old house, no one is there to give you love and affection, and you want to speak, weakness will choke your voice. So devotees are asking Krishna, oh Krishna, please allow me to do your bhajan from my childhood. So 50 years by sleeping and 80 to 100 years old age. So 50 plus 20, 70 years. 30 years remain there. If you want to be an expert, to income money, you need about 20 years. So 50 plus 20 plus 20 is 90. Only left about 10 years. Among these, oh, I have to marry, I have my girlfriend, boyfriend, I have to manage my material world. Where is time to do bhajan. So do bhajan in beginning time. If you do bhajan in childhood time, from childhood, then gradually, gradually, some impression will come in your mind, then your mind will not be disturbed. You can earn your money, you can do your job or business, same time do bhajan, then you can be happy. And how to do bhajan? And Prabhupada Maharaj taught, Guru Sushru Saya Bhakta, Sarvala Bharpa Nenacha, Sangyana Sadhu Bhaktanam, Ishtara Radha Nenacha. If you want to do bhajan, if you want to do bhajan direct, it is not possible. Prabhupada Maharaj instructing us, Guru Sushru Saya Bhakta, you have to serve your Gurudev with great honor. And which you possess, have to offer to Srila Gurudev, which you have, your mind, uncontrolled mind, have to offer to Gurudev. And which you possess in this world, we are not owner of this, have everything to donate to Gurudev. Then how you maintain my life? If you donate Gurudev, then Krishna will take care, don't worry. Then Gurudev will take care. We came in this world, we donate everything to Gurudev. We are well maintained or not? You can see we, how we are happy and Gurudev well maintained us. Sarvalabhar Panayanacha, Sangyana Sadhu Bhaktanam. Have to be always in good association. If you good association, then you can do bhajan, otherwise, not at all. So how you know who is Guru? And why we go to Guru? We may think, oh, we can see in internet, so many books available. Why to go to a mediator, like a broker? Guru is not like a material mediator or broker. Without the cosmic mercy of Gurudev, Krishna will not accept us. One devotee want to do bhajan, Krishna told, have you any bona fide guru? Devotee, no. Krishna told, Prathamam tu gurum pujya, tatastaiva mamarchanam, tadesa bhagavad bhakti, jannathani svaro bhavet. First go to worship the guru, take permission from him, then worship me. If you do so, it will bhakti, otherwise, one will go in vain. So, what is the symptom of guru? Then, mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, Tasmat gurum prapadeta, jigyasu sriuttamam, sati parichanisnatam, brahmanupa samasvayam. What is the symptom? Bhagavad is telling. Tasmat gurum prapadeta. For this reason, we have to go to guru. What is the reason? In this world, we are struck by threefold of miseries. If you want or not, we are bound to do that. Threefold miseries are, one is called adhyatmik, misery due to uncontrolled mind, adhidaivik, misery due to demigod, like sometimes dry, drought, sometimes snowstorm, sometimes flood, sometimes earthquake, happened due to demigods. We have been 3 days before we are Vancouver, there is heavy snowstorm, the demigods. And adi bhauti, the misery is caused by other living entity. So we want to get rid of these miseries, so we have to approach to Srila Gurudev. So what is symptom? It's two symptoms, one primary symptom, another secondary symptom. The primary symptom is one, and secondary symptom divided into two. The primary symptom, it must be realized soul. How you know that he realized soul or not? Have to go sadhu sangha. Goswami will tell he is realized soul or not. By your own idea, you could not judge him. And secondary symptom, sabde nishnatam means he must be expert all Vedic scriptures. If devotee or disciple has any doubt, quoted from scripture, he can rule it out. This is one symptom. Second one, upasamasyam, must be detached from material world. This material world, sankari for 3W or 3M. You may ask, what is 3W, 3M? 3W means the male person that hankering for 3W, woman, wealth, and wine. You can see the material world, the three things that hankering for this, male for woman, wealth, and wine. And 3M, for female, the hankering for men, money and marijuana. You must be detached from this 3W or 3M, and must realize so. If you so, then if you surrender to him, then your life will be successful, you will turn happy. So you are so fortunate, in front of us, so Guru is present here. So please, listen something for your lotusly, and if you do really bhajan, and want to be eternally happy, please surrender to him, And by initiated by him to do bhajan, the life is successful. There is no other way, no other way, no other way.
कृपा सिंहभ्यैवच पतितानं पावने वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो महापतन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदागय कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो नमः तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयाम चरणं
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माय हंबल ऑबेसेंसेस in the lotus feet of my spiritual master, Nitya Lila Praveshtam Vishnupa, Astotar Shishmat Bhakti Prakhyan Keshav Vrishlami Maharaj. And same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Nitya Lila Praveshtam Vishnupa, Astotar Shishmat Bhakti Vedan Swami Maharaj, and Prapujya Charan Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Parsishma Madhav Goswami Maharaj. In Srimad Bhagavatam, it has been told, after departure of Krishna from this world, Kali Yuga, iron is at once came to this world. So all the rishis and maharshis from whole India, about 60,000, they came to Navisharan on the bank of a river Gomati. And this question, Kaliyuga is coming. At that time, all ladies will give up their chastity. They will divorce their husband. Oh, not only 2, 3, 4 times, but they will record me up to 20, 25. And also, men will give up their religious mandate. They will also give up their, they will divorce their wives, and their son will not know that whom I am son. In the Kali Yuga, oh, so much suffering will come. Though so much advance of science will be, like he told, aeroplanes will be, it will be discovered, like mind it will go, and a few hours we can go around the whole world. Also, now computer and other systems are discovered. That is, science has more developed. If anyone brain is gone,
they can put another. If heart, they can put another heart. From kitchen room to all this dead hand, isn't it? But what became? They could not stop old days. They cannot stop our days. They are not infected. What is soul? That is, who are you? You should know that you are not this physical body. First, this body is a bag of urine, stool, blood and so on. If you open this, you will see nothing. Only these things. So you are not this body, but you are soul. Part and parcel of Supreme Lord. You have forgotten, and that is why you are coming in the rotation of birth and days, birth and days. And you are enjoying for endless pain of endless birth and day. We want happiness, but really we cannot be happy. For this whole world, their delegation have made a Sanjukta Rashtra. They want that whole world should be happy. But how they can do anything? So, what they are thinking? They want to make this body happy. But body, one day it will go away. What money you have collected at the time of death, you cannot take a farthing with you. Your relatives, son, daughter, husband, anyone will not go with you. So, in Srimad Bhagavat, it has been told, they are discussing all things. And in the meantime, Sukha Goswami, the disciple of Srila Sukadeva Goswami, appeared there. He came. They gave him Vyasasana. You are disciple of Sukadeva Goswami. You know Ved and Upanishad and everything from Parashara Rishi and others. You know everything. Please tell us how a soul will be happy. Jayatma samprasidat. Tanve bruhi jayatma samprasidat. He did not ask that how body will be happy. Because he knew that we are not body. By happiness of the body, soul cannot be happy. By eating, drinking and smoking. It may be temporarily your body may be healthy, but really not. Because you are not so. So what is the process that our soul may be healthy forever? And transcendental love and affection may be received. So, hearing this question, Sukha Goswami became very happy. He remembered all these sweet pastimes of Krishna. And he told, Savai Kunsam Paro Dharmo Yato Bhakti Rato Kaje Ahed Tukka Abda Bhakta Jayatma Sam Prasidhya. Parlanes wrote, Srila Rupa Goswami, very near and dear, Parikar of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He has written, Anna Abhilashita Sunyam, Gyan Karmat Janatutam, Ankulina Krishnam Silanam Bhakti Uttama. You should explain what is the meaning.
Sanjaya. Jnanatimarandasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmaye Sri Gurave Namaha Vancha Kalpatrubhyasya Kripa Sindhu Vevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. First of all, I offer my humble obeisances unlimited.
More Lord Dakuli.
Thousands of times under the lotus feet of my spiritual master, Om Vishnupada Paramahamsa Parivrakacharya Ashtadrata Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. I offer my humble obeisances thousands of times unto all the acharyas in the line of Sri Rupa Goswami. And also I offer my humble obeisances to all the Vaishnavas present, Siddhami Sannyasis, senior Vaishnavas, and Vaishnavis, and all God brothers, and all who have come here to hear Harikatha from the Lord's lips of Srila Gurudev. Srila Gurudev has ordered me to speak on the definition of pure bhakti as it has been given by Sri Rupa Goswami. This definition is complete. It is a very helpful for every sincere student, disciple who wants to progress in bhakti to remember what is the meaning of this particular shloka. Anya vilasita sunyam jnana karmadi anavritam anukulyena krishna anustilanam bhaktir uttama. Uttama bhakti, or the highest form of devotion, is that which is favorable for Sri Krishna, which brings happiness to Krishna, which is favorable for Krishna, and which is unbroken, uninterrupted, like a stream of honey. Not that we practice something, bhakti, for half an hour a day, and the rest of the day we do other things. This is something, but not complete, uttama, perfected bhakti. When we want to understand what is perfect, what is uttama, the highest form of bhakti, then 24 hours a day, as an unbroken chain, we are engaged in pure devotional services, which means favorable for Krishna, bringing pleasure to Krishna, uninterrupted, and under the guidance of Sadguru and pure Vaishnavas. Not only that, all our endeavors of mind, tongue, our words, our thoughts, our activities of our body, and the feelings, the moods which we have in our heart should only be directed to bring pleasure to Krishna. So this will only be known if we are under guidance of Sadhu, Sadguru, and Vaishnavas who are advanced. So this is the definition of pure bhakti. Then, most important for those who are not familiar with the association of sadhus, who have not the opportunity to be always under guidance, that we understand what are the obstacles to attain pure bhakti. We are living here and there, not always having association. So it is described in the beginning two lines, Anya Avilasita Sunyam Jnana Karmadi Anavritam, that we should not have any other desire but the desire only to bring happiness and pleasure to Krishna. If we have so many desires to make this body happy, to make our family happy, to be well known in society, that everybody likes me, these things are not favorable for pure bhakti. We should try to have only one desire, and that is how to bring happiness to Krishna. So if our intentions are covered with all these other desires, then pure bhakti is far away from us. Second line, jnana karmani anabhitam. It should not be covered by any activities, karma. Yeah. It should not be covered by any endeavors to obtain knowledge, especially the knowledge that we are one with Krishna, yeah, that we are all Brahm, we are all spirit. Yeah, this is very, very detrimental and very dangerous for pure bhakti. However, we cannot live without doing activities. We cannot live without having some information, gathering good knowledge. So that knowledge which is favorable, which is not covering our bhakti, that can be cultivated. And those activities which are not covering our activities to perform bhakti, yeah, that can be accepted. We can have a job, we can cook, we can chant, meditate, yeah, we can look after each other, as long as these things are not covering our desire to perform bhakti. Yeah, as long as they are beneficial, nourishing our bhakti, we can perform these activities. Not that we work, as Shripad Maharaj explained, only to gather money, money, money. But we are working to earn some money and just enough to keep body and soul together and spend the balance of our time to be in sadhu sangha, to practice the activities of uttama bhakti, shravanam, kirtanam, vishnu smaranam, achinam, vandanam, darshyam, satyam, atmani, vedanam. Those activities are described as the activities of swarup siddha bhakti. Those activities which form the very swarup of uttama bhakti. Not that we are engaged in aropa siddha bhakti. Yeah? We think that we are doing this for Krishna, working day and night, earning money, but have no time to hear. When sadhu comes, we have no time to hear because we have to earn money for Krishna. Or we are so busy that we have no time even to invite, yeah, sadhus. Or to chant, or remember, or read, we should be very careful that our bhakti doesn't become covert. That we can properly engage 24 hours gradually. It may be that at present we can do this for 2 hours, or 3 hours, or 1 hour, or half an hour. No harm, but we can increase gradually if we always remember that this is the barometer of our bhakti. Every evening we can think, remember how much today I was engaged in uninterrupted devotional services. And how much I will do tomorrow, like an expert businessman. He will think how much profit I have gathered today. Tomorrow I will try to earn more. So our bhakti should be like that. But every day we consider, what did I do today in order to serve Vaishnavas, to please Sri Guru? Because this is our life and soul. We may say, okay, I will please Krishna, I will make Krishna happy. But who is Krishna? Yeah. This is the first lesson when we take a serious interest in the process of bhakti. Krishna is Ashray Bhagavan and Vishay Bhagavan. We don't have any eyes to see Krishna. We think, oh, this is Krishna, I have a beautiful murti of Krishna. But we have no capacity to interact with Krishna because our senses are completely covered by the material energy. But Krishna is so kind. Yeah? He provides his pure representative, sends them to this world. But please, you go around and wake up everyone. You are eternal servant of Krishna. You don't belong in this world. You're supposed to be very happy. Yeah, always engage in activities to benefit others, yeah, especially to benefit Sri Krishna. Yeah. When will you come and join me in the spiritual world? Krishna is telling this in scripture, but we cannot hear and understand unless somebody says, come on, I will bring you to a pure devotee, a pure representative of Krishna. And that is called Ashraya Bhagavan. So Anya Abhilasita Sunyam. Yeah, if we apply this to Guru first, then we can very quickly make advancement. How can I please Gurudev? Yeah. How can I do that which is favorable for Gurudev? Assist him in one way or another. Then, very quickly, our bhakti will progress. So all of us have this opportunity, yeah, to see every day. What did I do today? No harm if you did half hour. Tomorrow, increase. Yeah? Gradually increase more and more. Invite sadhus, yeah, hear from them. And in this way, increase your understanding of the process of pure bhakti. And every day you will see that your life becomes more and more full of happiness, which we are all hankering for. As we have heard, happiness is not in this world. How many lifetimes did we try to enjoy sense gratification? Yeah? Thousands and thousands of lifetimes. And never we achieved it. Yeah? We are still hankering for sense gratification. But Krishna is telling, not in this life. In this human life, I have given you the opportunity to engage in devotional services. And by this you will be happy forever. Not only that, you will leave this cycle of birth and death and be with me forever. So don't misuse, as Srikant Maharaj so nicely presented, Prahlad Maharaj has taught, from young age we should engage in bhakti yoga. So Srila Rupa Goswami Pad has given us this complete definition. Take it with us and cherish this, and every day check how much we have advanced and our life will become successful. Apply this to Sri Guru, apply this to Vaishnavas, so that we can always have, yeah, that kind of opportunity to engage in the activities of pure bhakti.
In this definition, briefly we can tell the activities of body, mind and dhamma, and about this how that move. If it is done for to please Krishna, then it is bhakti. Whether Krishna is weeping or he is not happy, he that it means that he, this is not pure devotion or bhakti. From the example I am using, clearly find that in the arena of Kamsa, Krishna entered with the teeth of elephant. Some drop of blood was in their way, Krishna and Baladev. Entered, then Charu Musti. Oh, they were ready to fight with Krishna. And they challenged Krishna and Baladev. But Krishna told, I am like a baby boy, and you are so like mountain. How can I fight with you? Oh, I can wrestle from those who are equal to me in age. Then they told, you have killed Arhasu, Bakasu, Putana. You are not a small child. And telling, and they catch hold of the hand of Krishna and they brought them in arena. And they began to fight, to kill Krishna. Krishna was very happy that today I am enjoying this rush. But though Krishna is happy, but this is not bhakti. Pratikulena, not ankulena. They want to make Krishna, they wanted to kill Krishna. So this is not bhakti. And in other way, Mother Yashoda, you know that she binded Krishna in charted
order.
Krishna became very angry. And he was beating. This beating is it a Uttama Bhakti? Krishna is weeping here. Mother, mother, don't bind me. Don't beat me. I am weeping. Tears coming. Oh yes, it is beautiful. Because Yashoda mother is chastising, though he may be Parabrahma, Supreme Lord. But I am his mother. He should not be spoiled. So, I will chastise him. So, this is pure bhakti. For Krishna, I am giving an example to more clarify what is Uttamabha. You know that Maharaj Dasarath in Treta Yuga, to please his wife Kaikeyi, to fulfill his two bones, that Ramchandra should be exiled for 14 years and Bhat should be king of Ajodhya. Ram went to exile. And then Bharat, Sita and Lakshman also followed him. Bharat and Sardukna were not there. They were at the home of his material country. Maharaj Dasarath, he told Ram, Ha Ram, and left his body. He died. When Bhat and Shatrughna returned back to Ajodhya, they saw that Ajodhya is like a widow woman. No one is coming to him. All are waiting. What is the thing? Why they are getting me? They don't want to speak with me. Then he went to her mother and asked, oh, why all are sad here? Then she told, I took two bones from Maharaj Dasarath and he fulfilled my desire. So Ramchandra